understatement, don't you think? It panned out pretty unusual, to say the least, for what we probably expected. But the most important thing for us is the victory today. And I think that having slipped up in the first 10 minutes to not get an even bigger lead than we already had, looked like it was going to maybe bite us in the backside. But we managed to overcome that by adjusting our tactics at half time, having allowed Swansea to get in the lead even with 10 men. So the second half performance was exactly what we needed, a high press, closing down Swansea and forcing them into mistakes. And the fact that we've got the little man up front at the moment who's in terrific goal scoring form has ended up winning us the game, scored a hat-trick, scored two in the last game and converted most of the chances that we created for him. So a massive player for us at the moment, and the rest of the players provided that service for him today. So irrespective of what happened on what the referees or some of the referees' decisions were, we've gone and won away from home in an enormous game for both of us, because we've gained 3 points on everybody that's above us, which is massive in terms of the result today.
What did you make of the referees today, Sam?
I think he made some mistakes. I think he made some errors for both sides. I think that when a referee can make a decision that goes against you, then you don't want to be sat here having been punished by that mistake, by not picking up any points. We've come back to overcome the penalty decision and then win the game. But obviously, Swansea had some bad decisions for them as well, I think.
Sam, do you think Jimmy's goals are going to be the key to get you out of trouble?
I think so. I think everybody, if they're going to get out of trouble, or anybody, if they're going to succeed, you know, when you look at the two front men at Watford and then you look at the two front men at Leicester particularly, that those two score all the goals. We've got Jermaine scoring all our goals, so at the moment we've only got one, but one will be enough if he continues to score like he is. And they're the difference that change the game for you, put the game to bed when they get the opportunity, irrespective of whether you're in the dominant position at the moment or not. He can change a game in your favour by giving him one chance and him scoring.
How important, Sam, was it that you mentioned you adjusted tactics at half time, that you went and then left things up so quickly, and you know,
Well, I was imposing on the players that this is now a complete change of tactics. This is now a completely different situation where our front three with Jermaine in behind stay right up there, and our fullbacks push right on and give our width, and our wide men try and get in the hole between their defence and their midfield and play balls in there and then out. And of course, with Patrick's contribution today, it was apart from Jermaine scored an hat-trick, Patrick's massive contribution by the goal and providing goals and down the left-hand side. So all round, like I said, it's ended up a very, very good day for us and a very, very big 3 points.
Sam, what did you think of the red card from Norton?
I thought it was a soft red card.
Yeah.
I thought our penalty against us was a very, very soft penalty. And that changed the game at that particular point, because we were in total control at that point. And he's kicked the floor,
yeah,
and fell over. So, and we've had to overcome that. And of course, it didn't look like it was going to help us overcome it when he sent the player off for the tackle, but I thought it was a yellow card personally, because they went and scored. But, you know, we've gone and taken advantage of that. And like I said, it's not easy beating 10 men. Because, I mean, you know, I've won five games with 10 men at West Ham in my time. So when they got 2-1 up as well, that made it so much more difficult for us, because, you know, they've got something to protect then.
Was there any contact with Mvila at all, Sam, in the red card?
Yeah, it's contact.
Yeah, it looked like he might have got the ball cleanly.
Well, I don't think he got the ball, but I think he got, as always, the follow-through's caught him, you know, so I think that my interpretation as an old fart is not the interpretation anymore. because for me it's get up and get on with it, you know what I mean, and give him a foul. Now I'm encouraged to say the way the game is going and moved on rule wise, give him a yellow card but not to red, but you know the referee has a split decision to make in a few seconds. He's got a couple of wrongs, like I said, and hopefully he learns from that. Like I said, it hasn't affected us in the result. We've won it, and we're very, very pleased about that.
Do you think it's sense? I think it's only his fourth Premier League game tonight, do you think?
Well, he only stepped in because there was the referee who was supposed to referee the game was ill.
I know, but you would think they so, if they wanted to, found a more experienced ref. Do you think there's anything in that, or are you happy with the appointment?
Well, in his interpretation before the game, in his defence, I have to say, he pointed out that he knows how big this game is. It wasn't a case of him saying, I'm here, like I've stepped in, I know, lads, how big this game is for both of you. I'll try and manage it the best way I possibly can. So, you know, that's all you can ask of a referee. But like I said, things happen under pressure. And when people are under pressure, you know, they make mistakes, so...
Does winning here lessen the fatigue factor heading into Tottenham?
Yes, because placebo wise, we feel good, don't we? We don't feel as tired as after we've won as you know you were when you've lost, you know. So placebo wise, we are looking very good, you know. I mean, personally, I'd like to pay Darren Brown a lot of money and get him to come in and talk to my lads because I think he could do him the world of good after watching his programme last night. Did you watch it? Or watch Darren Brown?
When you first came in, you were talking about a lot of the iPad stuff and getting messages across to your players.
Yeah.
Do you like that sinking in now?
One would hope so, because like our week has been such a busy week that all we've been doing is visual, and we've trained only for this game, only once for half an hour yesterday on the pitch, tactically. So the rest of our tactical awareness was delivered to the players visually, and it'll be the same again. We'll stay here tonight, we'll recover tomorrow. Some of the lads that didn't play will do a little bit of training, do a bit of football if we can find a bit of dry ground. Then we'll travel to London by coach. Les at QPR have generously offered a training ground for us, but that'll be 15 minutes warm up, 25-30 minutes with a team that's very, very tired, just going through how to try and get a result against Tottenham. And again, visually, we'll give them what Tottenham, you know, can do and what in terms of strengths and weaknesses.
Will that be enough?
Who knows? We'll have to wait and see. Hope the win spurs them on tonight. This was much more important winning this game than getting anything against Tottenham, as this was a 6-pointer. You know, you mentioned the distance we'd have to catch up. Had Swansea beat us tonight, would have been massive.
Sam, did your players watch the magic show by Darren Brown as well?
I wouldn't have thought so.
Asleep,
you know what I mean? I just love Darren Brown. I think he's unbelievable in terms of his, you know, how he manipulates and makes people perform by suggesting certain words and stuff like that. It's absolutely out of this world, like you mean. So you'll all watch it then, won't you? So you'll know what I mean next time you see me, okay?
Can you use that on the
player? I don't know. Might be banned.